If you have entered many transactions into your QuickBooks file, it would be helpful for you to be able to search and find the things you're looking for. There are four common tools that will help you find anything you need. Even though you already know how to find things from your reports, and even though you already know how to find things in the register, these four tools will also help you find anything that you put. They are the Customer Center, the Vendor Center, the Find tool, and the Search tool. Let's take a look at each of these one by one. From the icon bar, click Customers, and the Customer Center will open up. All you have to do is click on a particular customer or income source, and you will be able to see every transaction for that particular customer. For example, Molly's Saloon is one of Joe's income sources. And if you notice, all you have to do is click and select Molly's Saloon, and you can see every single transaction that you had with Molly's Saloon, like the deposit you made on June 1 into M&T Bank for your $1,000 paycheck, or the deposit that you made into Chase Bank that you got from Molly's Saloon, check number 88, for $1,400. The Vendor Center is exactly the same. You can click Vendor, and you'll get a list of every person or company whom you've ever paid. When you click and select that company, for example, Verizon, you can now see every single check or every single transaction that you had with Verizon. Notice that back on June 4th, you wrote them a check from M&T Bank for $250. And you'll notice also for Verizon, on June 17th, you charged on your Citibank credit card $145 to Verizon. All you have to do is click on any other vendor, for example, FedEx, and you will see each transaction, where the money came from or to, as well as the amount and the date. The Find tool is another useful way for you to find and manage your QuickBooks file. The Find tool allows you to find transactions by amount, find by transaction type, like check, credit card charge, or deposit. It also allows you to search and find by date. There's also an ability to find by person, but you might not need that because you already know how to use the Customer and Vendor Center. You can also use the Advanced Find, which I will give you a small overview of. And if you like to use the Advanced Find, I recommend that you watch additional QuickBooks videos on how to use them. Let's take a look at how to use the Find tool. From the top left of the main menu, click Edit, Find, and the Find window opens up. Most companies have many different types of transactions, but since you are an individual, you're more likely to be searching for a particular check. You can search for a particular check just by the number. Let's find check number 3. Click in the number field, type the number 3, and click Find. Now notice, two checks with the check number 3 came up. Why is that? Well, one of them was made payable to Capital One on June 19th, and another check number 3 back on June 13th was paid to Con Edison. But how could you have the same check number for two different payees? Very simple. They came from two different bank accounts. If you need more information about the check, you can double-click. And this window that opens up shows you everything that you put about that particular check. Even though this check was recorded in the register, when you double click from the Finder, that particular check will open up in this window. Notice this check number 3 that was written to Capital One on June 19 is from the Chase bank account. However, if we double click the other check number 3, we can see that this check number 3 was written from the M&T bank account, and it was paid to Con Edison for electricity on June 13th. If you want to find any deposit or credit card transaction, you will have to use the advanced find in the same window. For example, let's find every deposit more than $600. From the main menu, click Edit Find, then you have to choose the Advanced tab. After you click on the Advanced tab, you have to scroll all the way down till you get to the choice Transaction Type. Click on Transaction Type, and then a pull-down menu appears showing you every possible transaction type in QuickBooks. In our case, we're looking for a deposit. Now notice when you choose deposit, that criteria gets put here on the choice list on the right. Leave that alone and then scroll all the way up and choose amount, because we're looking for a deposit of a particular amount. And the amount we're looking for is greater than or equal to $600. Now when we click Find, you have every deposit in this file that's greater than $600. Don't forget, if you double click on it in the Find window, it will open up in a deposit window. And even though you recorded this deposit in the register, QuickBooks considers it recorded in this window, and you can see all the details about this deposit. What about this? We would like to see every credit card transaction before June 9th. So, from the main menu, we click Edit, Find. You must choose the Advanced tab, and because we're looking for a particular transaction type, we have to scroll down in the filter box. Click Transaction Type, and then in the new pull-down menu, choose Credit Card. Now, if you click Find, you will get every single credit card transaction in the file. When you click Reset, everything clears itself. So you would have to go down again and find Transaction Type, and choose Credit Card. But if you want to see more detail, in other words, we don't just want every credit card transaction, we want every credit card transaction after June 9th. So we then have to scroll up and go to date, because now we're also finding by date, and we want to find every credit card transaction from June 1 to June 9. Now when we click Find, we notice there are only 6 matches. That means there are 3 transactions, because when you use the advanced find, it always puts 2 lines for every 1 transaction. This is something that comes from accounting. Now this find window is very helpful. So this will be the last window that will fill the last open spot in our icon bar. I suggest you click View, Add Find to the icon bar, and click OK. And now we have it available anytime we need. It'll actually remember the recent search, so you should probably click Reset before you add it to the icon bar. The search tool is one of the best things in QuickBooks you can use to find something you're looking for. The search tool will search through every field of every piece of information in the file to find the matching text that you put. So then you will ask, where did you put text? Well, transactions have a memo for text. So if you recorded a detailed memo about an explanation regarding a transaction, that would be text that the search tool could use to help find that transaction. Another place that you sometimes type in text is the address of the customers and vendors. So if you're looking for a customer or vendor on a particular street, you can use the search tool to find that customer or vendor. For example, let's imagine that the Beer and Go is on Honeywell Street, and you put that in the address when you set up that income source. Let's also imagine that FedEx delivered the June 7th to Honeywell Avenue. This is all relevant because you're going to type in the word Honeywell into the search bar, and you will see both of these things. One is a street address, the other is a transaction, but they will both come up in the search result list. In the top right of the icon bar is the search tool. Click in it and type in the word or words that you're looking for. Oops. Honeywell. Now, normally when you click this eyeglass, results would come up here on the right. Now, right now it's just searching, but what you should see in a minute is a list of every item in this QuickBooks file with this word Honeywell. And you will see whose address it's in, and you will see which checks, deposits, or credit card transactions this word is a part of. In my case, the computer or the QuickBooks is not working properly because you would normally see it listed here. And then, of course, you could click on it and see which one it is. Since my computer is not currently working properly regarding the search bar in QuickBooks, I'm going to include in this video a clip of another video that I made for someone else to use the search tool. The only difference is that other individual is actually a business, but the idea of using the search bar tool is the same. So just watch the results as you see it in the remaining part of the video, and I'm sure you will be able to use the toolbar to its full advantage. And now we will learn how to use the search bar, which is a tool that allows you to find any item of text in any of the records in the QuickBooks file. And now we will learn how to use the search bar, which is a tool that allows you to find any item of text in any of the records in the QuickBooks file. For example, let's find every instance of the word cookie. We go to the search bar and we type it in, and then when we click the eyeglass, we notice it's searching now. And now notice, two items or two instances of the word cookie are somewhere in Steve Thomas's file. The first instance is in this invoice to Truce Brothers, and the second one is in the customer records for Giovanno. If we double click this particular transaction, okay, we can click open to open it up, we see, and in the bottom left corner of this invoice where it says memo, I purposely wrote, remember to bring cookie. The other instance of the word cookie is in the customer records, Giovanazzo. So if I click open here, I can get the customer center and it highlights the one with the word cookie in the record. When I double click, I can see that I purposely put the word cookie in Giovanazzo's address just to illustrate this point. And that's how you can use the search bar to your advantage.